A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 13th August, on the front page you have, in Mansarovar, Chinese lend a helping hand to Indian pilgrims. So this is regarding the Kailash Mansarovar Yatra. So for Indian pilgrims on this difficult trek to the high altitude Kailash Mansarovar, which is the Hindu holy site in Tibet, here Chinese officials have been very cooperative and they have been lending a helping hand. Then this is Kashmir Valley kept under lockdown during Eid festival. So main mosques in Srinagar remain out of bounds and stole pelting has been seen in some areas. Then this is India-China relations in context of Kashmir. Here we see the External Affairs Minister representing India saying that the decision on Kashmir doesn't affect line of actual control. So that is the LAC. So across in Jammu and Kashmir, we have one border within Jammu and Kashmir as such on the western side, which is line of control LOC, which beyond which we have Pakistan occupied Kashmir, and on the eastern side we have another line, another border within Jammu and Kashmir, which is LAC, line of actual control. So that is the area of Jammu and Kashmir state which is under Chinese control. So that is mostly uninhabited area and it was occupied by China during the India-China war in 1962. Then below you have Mukesh Ambani unveils Jio fiber service for fixed broadband. So here you can see, after disrupting the mobile telephony market and becoming India's largest profitable telecom company, Mukesh Ambani led Reliance Jio plans to disrupt the fixed broadband market with the launch of Jio fiber on September 5. So Jio Fiber will offer free voice calls for life from landline phones, high speed broadband of a minimum speed of 100 Mbps and a free HD TV and dish with monthly plans starting from 700 and going up to 10,000. On page 4 you have DDA, Delhi Development Authority, demolished Ravidas temple, took away idols. So this is what Aam Aadmi Party minister says, and the party has even written to Prime Minister urging him to ask DDA to rebuild the structure. So this is Sant Guru Ravidas temple in Tughlukabad which has been brought down. Then on page 5 you have, from Assam to Chhattisgarh, a maiden 1,500 km journey for wild buffaloes. So 5 female wild buffaloes will be translocated to Raipur in Chhattisgarh from Assam to revive the waning population of the endangered species in central India. This is said to be the longest such translocation in the country ever. So from Assam, it will go to Udanti Wildlife Sanctuary in Raipur district in Chhattisgarh. On page 8 you have Wildlife Sanctuary set to expand boundaries. So this is Krishna Wildlife Sanctuary. The Forest Department has identified 308.84 hectares of revenue land for inclusion in the sanctuary as recommended by the National Board for Wildlife. So this step has been taken to compensate for the land which has been diverted for setting up missile test launch facility by DRDO in the Krishna district in the Wildlife Sanctuary region. On page 9 you have headgear made mandatory for children above 4 years. So safety measures for children traveling on motorcycles have been brought into effect now by the government passing the act, that is Motor Vehicles Amendment Act 2019. Then below you have no toxic chemicals in PET bottles. So this is Council for Scientific and Industrial Research Institute, that is Central Food Technology Research Institute, which in Mysore, which conducted a study and concludes that metals and chemicals are below detection level in PET bottles. So these are polyethylene terephthalate bottles, PET bottles, which are generally used for packaged drinking water. And this is PM's health insurance scheme will cover cancer treatment also, says officials. So government has realized that cancer care costs are causing massive financial crisis. So now Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, which provides up to 5 lakh coverage per family per year. So this will also cover cancer treatment. On the editorial page, you have the first editorial, Crisis as Opportunity. So this is regarding crisis within Congress. The Nehru-Gandhi dynasty must withdraw without leaving a vacuum in the Congress, is what this editorial says. And the second one, Strongman Candidate. So this is regarding Gotabaya nomination. It says that the Gotabaya Rajapaksa nomination in Sri Lanka as a presidential candidate may strengthen view that Rajapaksas are pursuing family interests. Then the lead article is an abrogation of democratic principles. So this article says that Kashmir move affects the robust nature of Indian democracy in addressing internal conflicts and alienation. So, without using democratic principle, using force, the changes have been brought about in Jammu and Kashmir, which is covered in this article. And this is the countering the rights hegemony. So, this talks in a fight back, only a deep fostering of intra-subaltern solidarity using culture can help. So, the rights mean as such, you know, has become powerful, and the Dalits, the OBCs, the minorities are targeted. So how this right hegemony can be countered? So it says that this article says that this can only happen with intra-subaltern solidarity, means among the community there should be solidarity using culture. The word subaltern means lower castes as such, so in the community, the lower strata in the society. On op-ed page, you have the perilous state of academic freedom. So this says the present wave of anti-intellectualism, where informed opinions are ridiculed, poses a serious threat. So these days, whatever is spread becomes the news, becomes the knowledge as such, and and anti-intellectualism wave, which has been seen, that somebody who has informed opinion is ridiculed. That person is in a minority. So this issue is a serious threat, which is being spoken of in this article. And this is rooting artificial intelligence in ethics. So artificial intelligence is a technology, but then this article says it should be evaluated both on the basis of its utility and the intention of its creator. So ethics with artificial intelligence is very important. Then on page 12, you have prosecution nod for 80 official spending. So now we see that there are 80 officials who have been charged under Prevention of Corruption Act, and their files are pending with various departments. So this issue is covered here. You can see there are 4 IAS officers as well within this. Then this is Army plans to raise age of retirement of skilled staff. So this is a proposal which aims to retain experts and reduce pension costs. So Army has conducted a new study on age enhancement for retirement of personnel in specialized areas to retain skilled manpower. On page 13, you have Center asks Twitter to block accounts spreading falsehood. So this is saying that many are posting objectionable content on Jammu and Kashmir, and Center has asked Twitter to take down several accounts on its platform posting such objectionable and malicious content, particularly relating to Jammu and Kashmir. On international page, you have coverage on Hong Kong. This is China saying that Hong Kong is showing sprouts of terrorism. Protesters are using dangerous tools to attack the police and to commit serious crimes. So, now action in Beijing in Hong Kong is feared. And this is US tightens rules for green card seekers. So US President Donald Trump unveiled a rule that could deny green cards to immigrants who use public assistance such as Medicaid, food stamps, housing vouchers, etc. So this is considered one of the most aggressive moves to restrict legal immigration. On business page, you have the full coverage on the front page news on Jio Fiber. So that is also there, and regarding Reliance Industries moves to restructure its balance sheet. Then this is S Cup brims with losses, center to hold meeting with tea sector chiefs. So tea sector is also under stress. So more than 80% of Indian Tea Association members have incurred losses in 2018-19. So now center will hold meeting. So with the T sector chiefs. And this is taxes making capital market unattractive. It is said India is the only nation to tax equity trading. So this is taxation issue being covered here. So these are the important headlines. The last page also has current has sports news. So these were the headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Sorry, there has been a lag in coverage of current affairs, but soon we may be able to come back again. Thank you, and sorry for the inconvenience.